Second function in renal system, you can see in renal system, what does it do? Prostaglandin again, E2 and I2. These are constitutive prostaglandins. Everywhere normal prostaglandins is E and I2. Okay. These are always, you will see E and I2 are normal type of prostaglandins. You will see E at least, mainly E. But E is essential. You can remember mainly E is present everywhere. E is everywhere. E is essential. That's why you can remember E2. So what is the function of this? Actually, function of this prostaglandin to dilate blood vessels. Blood vessels that actually supply blood to renal glomerulus. What is glomerulus? Renal has tubules. This is renal kidney has tubules. Glomerulus, it has got the proximal convoluted tubules. Then it has got, this is loop of Henle. And then again, distal convoluted tubules. And then this will reach to collecting duct and then to ureter, then to bladder, urinary bladder. So this is how here blood vessels are present. So blood will be filtered here. Now this blood, first blood that the blood vessel through which blood go is called efferent blood vessels, efferent arteriole. So this efferent arteriole will be dilated by prostaglandins E2. Because of this dilatation, blood flow will increase. So we require high blood flow to ensure good filtration of blood, good purification of blood. You know, the kidney purify blood. So this is done by efferent, is actually vasodilatation of efferent is done by this. And as a result, plasma, renal plasma flow will increase, glomerular filtration rate will increase, and kidney will function normally. See, if you put this non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs, what will happen? Side effect. So that previously dilated efferent will not dilate. What will happen? The adverse effect, the blood will reach here, low amount of blood will reach. As a result, what will happen? Low blood filtered. So blood purification will not be proper and kidney will also not get proper blood. So if you use this in long term, so this it can cause kidney damage. It can cause kidney damage. So kidney failure in long term use. Here, peptic ulcer, here kidney damage because of this use. Why? Because this NSAID inhibits the normal function. So if you study when you understand the significance of something, when something is deficient, then you will understand the real significance. For example, your friend, until your friend is friends and your parents are with you, you don't understand the significance. Once they are away from you, then you will understand the significance. So you can see this NSAID make them away. And then as a result, peptic ulcer and this kidney failure. So this prostaglandin, you can see preventing this kidney failure, protect normal function, protecting this intestine, okay, from ulcer. So these two functions are very important. And you can see P for pain. Also remember prostaglandin for pain, inflammatory function, P for pain. We'll talk about that.